And now we're moving on to what I consider probably the hardest hardest group of Pokemon I'll ever have to talk about, which is fire type. Honestly, if I were to be a Pokemon gym leader, I would probably end up being a fire type, just because I pretty much love every fire type that comes out. Lit Leo is just probably the cutest thing you've ever seen, and it turns into probably one of the most regal looking Pokemon on the planet as far as the animal kingdom is concerned. I just love it, you know, it's got like a flame mane, you know, and the first gen came up with probably some of the best fire type Pokemon out there. You got Magmar, Ponyta, Rapidash, Flareon, obviously the Charizard line, Charmander line, which is, I mean, it's really, 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 really cliche going on the fire type Charmander line, but honestly, God, Charizard is probably one of my favorite fire type Pokemon just because of how he looks. So he just looks so incredibly good. And, you know, just watching him troll the hell out of Ash and the enemy is just one of my probably favorite things in the world, you know. It sucked that he couldn't come through in the Pokemon League in the first gen, but, you know. It's just as funny as hell watching this gigantic fire lizard basically trolling the other way now out of a little kid, you know. And, you know, he's got to be up there as far as one of my favorites. But honestly, I think my favorite fire type Pokemon altogether would have to be Blaziken. And again, it kind of breaks down to the Mega Evolution, which I used a ton of in my DVD and off the top. I think it's the Pokemon I always chose. Torchic was always my starter Pokemon, no matter what. Every playthrough I've ever done, I think I only ever not picked Torchic one time, and that was to pick Mudkip. And while I was with Mudkip, I honestly just felt kind of weird picking a Pokemon that wasn't Torchic to be my starter. Because I have to say, maybe the first four generations, my starter was the fire. I always picked Charmander, I always picked Cyndaquil, I always picked Torchic, and I always picked my, can't remember what his name is, but I can't remember what the Fireman's name is. I'm trying to have this thing really like to be, you know, well informed when it comes to Pokemon. So, choices to come up with as far as what I thought would be my favorite, just because I literally love almost every fire type I've come across. It honestly got me a little upset that you changed phone numbers in half of fire type in Gen 8. Like, it just annoyed me. Granted, the fairy type looks cute, no? It's a very pretty design, but to me it drives me up the wall that they took away the fire setting, which for me was one of the better things about it. And, you know, of course I'll probably get some arguments about how, you know, Ponyta Flareon form better than his regular form or whatever, but, and that's fine, I mean, there's an argument to go for that too, I suppose, but for me, his fire typing was what made him one of the better Pokemon in Gen 1, so it's just kind of like, for them to take that away, it's just kind of hurt me a little bit. You know, granted, it's something I quickly got over, because I, you know, just don't hang out of crap like that, but for me, right, them taking away the fire type is one of the things that's really actually crazy, you know. It's just, I honestly, even with Delphox, having Delphox being the first fire type, I really didn't pick them in the universe, or not universe, Talos regions. Oh no, I wasn't. It was Universe. Yep. I honestly got it. It was one of the first fire types that I never picked as my starter. Just because of, the fact that just, I wasn't a huge fan of it. It was final evolution. I do not like Delphox. Even to this day, I don't even like the shiny form. Normally I like Pokemon because of the shiny form. But honest to God, I love the Decidueye, but having a shiny form be black and green like that, that kind of upped the light factor for it at many times over. So for me, like the shiny form for Delphox seems so just unpalatably ugly. It's just kind of, other people can like it, but for me, that's just, Delphox is probably my least favorite fire type as far as like woods go. My favorite fire type would have to be Blaziken, just because it looks mega. Like, mega just looks really freaking awesome. And that was probably one of the few Pokemon that I didn't mind mega evolving for. Mega evolving Constructor, Gigantamax, and even Two Crystals was a neat gimmick, and I liked it, but it just kind of all fits back into my impatience towards having those gimmicks take forever to actually go through and all that. And then, granted, Mega Fighting or Mega Evolving was something that stuck around until your Pokemon died or the battle was done, but it just was another one of those things where it just, I want this battle done now, and I gotta wait an extra couple of minutes just to get through this mega evolution. That's just kind of, So, yeah, for me, the fire typing would have to be Blaziken. Next, we're talking about flying types, and for me, again, flying types is one of the Pokemon where it's kind of hard to come up with, because I'm very, very, very partial to the bird type Pokemon in the game. My bird type Pokemon, so bird type not being an actual type. But all the bird like Pokemon, like I said, I've basically always and forever caught and kept the early route bird Pokemon. The Pidgeys, the Swallows, the Rookidees, the, except for Spearow. I never kept Spearow on my team, and I don't know why. I just never had a connection to Spearow. To me, the thing, we had to know Spearow is ugly. I just never felt aesthetically attracted to bird Pokemon, and in general, flying types. Because even the worst flying types are still pretty okay flying types. But yeah, for me, honest to God, again, it's kind of all kind of comes down to its mega form, but Pidgeot. Pidgeot's my favorite flying type. And honest to God, in most of my Pokemon games, if there's a chance to have a Pidgeot on my team, I jump on it. Not so much in the mega evolution portion of it, but just because it's just this very streamlined, very sleek, very aerodynamic looking bird. And Ash having his Pidgeot kind of made me want my own Pidgeot. And I like, you know, the way it looks. I like the way it flies. I like that, you know, I just like it. And the Mega Evolution is just beautiful, to be honest. It's just so very rainbowy, very colored, and very vibrant. And it's just an awesome looking Pokemon. And it just, again, flying types is one of those types where it is very hard for me because I like almost all flying types, like I like almost all fire types. But, you know, gun to my head, if you were to tell me I had to pick a favorite, you know, flying type, it would absolutely be Pidgeot. Again, it kind of breaks down to its mega form just as much as it does it break down to its normal form. And it just works, you know, and I like Workin too, and I absolutely love Corviknight, which is funny for me because when the game was first announced and Corviknight was first revealed, I didn't like it. I did not like the way it looked. I thought it looked hideous, I thought it looked ugly, I thought it just, I didn't like it. I didn't think it would work. And then I caught one of my own, and Rookie and Corvus Flyer by itself were just game-changing game savers. Like, they bailed me out of so many battles just on their own. Like, I've been quite a few of the gym leaders, as you guys will see, with just Corvus Flyer, or at the very least, you know, if you jam from Corvus Flyer. And, or not Corvus Flyer, but Corviknight, all Corvus Flyer, Rookity, and Corviknight all played major battles, major parts in almost all of my battles. But I believe, as you guys see later on in the gameplay, that it was Corviknight that initially got me the win from Rayhan. Because for whatever reason, I struggled a lot with Rayhan, mostly because of the Rallodon. Like, I got in there thinking that Cinderace would be the solution to the Rallodon problem, and then I got him facing the Rallodon, and just, I barely put a nick in that dude, and it's just kind of blew my mind that the Rallodon could tank that shot. It was supposed to be a field type, so I thought it would have at least somewhat of effectiveness against, you know, against it, but I guess I overestimated its ability. But, yeah, honest to God, Corviknight bailed me out quite a few battles, but it you know, was so late into the game that it just kind of, it's hard for me to put Corviknight over Pidgeot as a favorite flying type. Just with everything I've experienced from it, just, for me, it's a very narrow margin, but it's, you know, Pidgeot as a Corviknight, without question. And I think that might be the last official list I struggle with outside of maybe water type. Because again, water type is another type that I used almost exclusively in every single Pokemon game for the certain portion of the game. Plus, you know, it has quite a few type advantages, so it made it quite easy to battle a lot of people in the game, just on the type of game it alone. So, but yeah, I'd say Pidgeot is my favorite one type, and this may be the last list that kind of is a struggle for me as far as what to pick. But yeah, I would say Mega Pidgeot and Mega Pidgeot for a type. Next, we're going to talk about glitch-type Pokemon. And for me, there's a couple of glitch-type Pokemon that I like to, you know, the Litwicks. I like the idea of the close candle. Not a huge fan of how Shin Wood kind of comes out, but I don't hate the design. I'm just, you know, not a huge fan of it. But honestly, like, that's just for me, like, ghost type Pokemon, and then we go to the Zelda with Gengar. And, it's just always been a fan of Gengar, you know, there's also, you know, Dusknoir is pretty much a tank in ghost form. But, I haven't used Dusknoir nearly as much as I have Gengar, and most of that has to do with, you know, well, actually, I think now it's gigantic. So I really love the fact that Gengar is gigantic. It really comes from the floor and looks like a triangle opening. It's just it's pretty cool and it's shiny and it's even better. But I don't know, I've always just been a huge fan of Gengar, you know, just for nostalgic purposes. I haven't really used any ghost types, honestly. Yeah, I'd like to stick to the starter water flyer team, and then just kind of have random Pokemon on my team as I go. But whenever I had Gastly on my team, I didn't have too much of a terrible time with him, and he wasn't the best Pokemon in the game, but I feel like Gengar by himself is just, you know, pretty awesome looking. And then you added Gigantamax to him, and then kind of makes up for how kind of awful gas you can start out with. You know? Yeah, I don't know. For me, it sucked that, you know, in the earlier games, you couldn't get them unless you traded them. Quite frankly, I didn't have a lot of friends that I had regular contact with that had Pokemon for a trade table, so it kind of made it hard to get my hands on it. Gengar, but, you know, now you can literally get a Gengar, you know, at the snap of a finger, it makes it a little bit easier. And it makes them a little more viable. But, you know, at least for me, it's just watching other people use Dusknoir and watching how the thing can tick kind of impressed me. But for me, as a person, it's Gengar. Just goes, it was Gigantamax form, but before that, it was just how often I'm actually using him on my team. You know, I know he's not like the strongest ghost type or the best stat wise, but I don't know. I had fun with him in the number one when I could. I've got, you know, quite a few Gengar, you know, in my Pokemon home from my Pokemon. And some new, and maybe the Alpha Sapphire always has been the one between me. But before that, it was pretty hard for me to get, you know, for me to get my hands on one, just because, like I said, I didn't know anybody that I could regularly have contact with that could create my Pokemon. The only one I really knew was the son of an old coworker of my mom's, who was, you know, just a bigger Pokemon fan as I was, maybe even bigger, that had a trade table and I got one of them. So whenever I needed to do my trading, I'd have to wait, you know, a couple of months until she got her son in, and I'd get ready with my mom, and, you know, we would trade then. But sorry about that, and so was the coming and asking a couple of questions about the title working. And yet again, at work, recording messages, so if you hear any noises in the background, please forgive me. We're the only place that can do this recording. I don't have a recording room in my apartment yet. I hope for the two bedrooms eventually, but at the moment, the only one with my mom. It's a little hard to do voiceover recordings when I'm not playing the game when my wife's in mind, so. Anywho, but while I was talking to my coworker and answering his questions or whatever, there was another Pokemon that I thought of that I also liked, but doesn't take the favorite Pidgeot and Gengar, and that was Panic. I just love the idea of a possessed dog. That's an unfortunate backstory, obviously, but I love the idea of a possessed dog, especially when it has a different mouth and it's mega. It's even cooler having multiple parts of it coming out of zippers. But, yeah, all in all, I'd say Gengar would be the Pokemon that I would consider my favorite for those Pokemon. Based off of my recent, I wanted to say Mega Evolution. Well, actually, Mega Evolution is pretty cool too, but I suppose it's a Gengar. But, yeah, Gengar would be my best bet.